And then we're going to begin. And we won't be here long, so hallelujah. You know, we're in 2019. Isn't that a blessing?
Yes.
For us to say we can experience it and be a part to partake of it. You know, the number 19 means faith.
Yes.
It means God's perfect order.
Yes.
And it also means the spiritual enlightening that God wants to do in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
So to allow him to do that, we have to be at a place where we're not blind in our spirit. Amen? And if you look in the book of Isaiah in chapter 29, God was speaking to the people because they were spiritually blind to the things that God wanted to do. Now, intellectually, they understood. But spiritually, when you are in tune with God in the spirit, then the Holy Spirit, God calls him what? The teacher, the advocate. The Bible says that the Spirit of God is everything that we need. Amen? So it is by the Spirit that we get instruction for what God wants to do in our lives. So I've already been crying out before the Lord and said, Lord, in 2019, I want to allow you to do all that you desire to do in me and through me. Amen? So I understand already that that can't happen out of my intellect alone. Amen? See, intellectually, you can only go so far in God. But for the things that God wants to do through you and I, born again believers, it's a supernatural work. A supernatural work can't be done intellectually. It can't be done out of our humanness. It has to be done by the Spirit of the Lord. Amen? And you can't allow the Spirit to move if you're not in tune with what the Spirit is doing. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we're going to see God. Do you all desire to see God move?
Yeah.
Amen.
Well, I don't know about you, but last year, in the middle of the year, I was just sick and tired of a good word. I want to see the manifestation of the power of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And see, that's what God's going to do in this house in 2019. The word is alive and the word is powerful. So we should see life being exemplified and manifested in the house of God. Church service, but a heart that desires to change and see God move.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Lord. See, God loves us.
Yes, yes.
Ooh, he loves us.
Thank you, Lord.
And I want us to hear the love of God and what God is sharing with us and how much he loves us in Isaiah 29, 13 and 14. Huh. Oh, yeah. Because, see, sometimes we think we're a little further along in God than we really are. But God really sees where we are.
Yes.
And so I want you to hear, this was a prophecy from Isaiah that he gave to the people of Israel. And his instruction was, I want you to hear this prophecy, not just in your intellect, but I want you to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying.
Yeah.
And it says, stop, pause, and listen.
Yes.
So if we look at I went ahead of myself. Start at verse 9, Isaiah 29. Verse 9, just back up a little bit. In this prophecy, he's saying, stop and take some time and wonder at this prophecy. Hallelujah. Stop and take some time. That means pause and wonder at this prophecy. If you choose whether you understand it or not, soon you will witness the actual event and be confounded reluctantly. Blind yourselves now, if you choose, take your pleasure, and then be blinded at the actual occurrence. They are drunk, but they're not drunk from wine. They stagger, but not from strong drink, but from a spiritual stupor. So the Bible is making it plain here. When we're in a place where we're in a spiritual darkness, we're moving. We're going to church, we're spending time in the Word of God, we are even quoting Scripture, but if our spirits are not, our hearts are not connected to the very Spirit of God, then the Bible says we're in a spiritual blind stupor. But in 2019, God wants to have a spiritual awakening in our lives, amen? And so I believe the same prophecy that he gave to the people of Israel here, he's given to us in 2019. Because this is the year of the order of God and to see the strength of God manifested in our lives. Amen? So let's look here at 29, and I'm going to go to verse 13. And it reads, hallelujah. Because this nation approaches me only with their words and honors me only with their lip service, but they remove their hearts far from me, and their reverence for me is a tradition that is learned by rote without any regard for its meaning. Hallelujah. Let's look at that again. And the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near to me, desire to be close to me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but remove their hearts and their minds far from me, and their fear and reverence for me are a commandment of men that is learned by repetition without any thought or any meaning. Amen? Amen. And see, as Christians, it's easy for us to come to that place. But here's what I love about the love of God, because he knows where we are. Here's what he says in the next scripture. Therefore, behold, which means to look and see, I will again do marvelous things with this people, marvelous and astonishing things, and the wisdom of their wise men will perish, and the understanding of their discerning men will vanish and be hidden. So God is saying, even though we're coming after him, and all we're coming after from instruction and from rope, from what we heard, he still honors that. But what I want you to do is understand, if you're going to move by my supernatural power, I need your heart. Amen? I don't just need you to understand and do a lot of things because you've been told, lift your hands and praise me. Come to church and serve me. Where is the personal private time with me? Are you actually building a relationship with me? See, without a relationship, there can be no spiritual life and change. Amen? Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. But God is saying, even though I know you're honoring me with your lips, and you're doing it because you've been told to, and you understand you should do it, but I want you to understand how to move by my spirit, because my spirit is leading and guiding you to move. Amen? Because see, there is a difference. Oh, there is a great big difference. Hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah. And so God says, 2019, I'm going to do marvelous works through my people that will connect their heart with me. Oh yeah, I'm going to do marvelous works through my people. And we just saw that in the scripture. So we're talking about a spiritual awakening. Now let's talk, I'm going to go to take it a little bit deeper. Hallelujah. See, God has a plan and a purpose, and Pastor Elliot touched on it this morning for each and every one of us. Amen? A plan and a purpose for each and every one of us. But first we have to understand and realize, because sometimes as Christians, we don't recognize the power and the true work of the Holy Spirit. But you know, the Holy Spirit is really not his name, it's his function. Amen? Because see, there is God the Father, there is God the Son, and there is God the Holy Spirit. See, God the Father spoke, and he created the heavens and the earth. God the Son came in the form of the powerful God in the Spirit. Amen? But now God the Holy Spirit lives in every born again believer, so we can now begin to fulfill the very promise and plan that God has for our lives. Oh, hallelujah. So if you can't recognize him as a person and as God and don't begin to commune with him in that way, your heart will remain far from him. Amen? At best, you'll live a life as a Christian and it'll only be out of your intellect. But we got to get past intellectual spirituality this morning. Amen? We got to go to a place where we find God right in the specifics of what he wants to do. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah.
Amen.
See, he is God the Holy Ghost. He is God the Holy Spirit. So when you rise up in the morning, don't just say God, say Holy Ghost, because that's the teacher for today, for you and me. Amen? He is the power in this earth to bring change from us. Amen? Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. See, the Bible references the Holy Spirit as a treasure.
Yes.
Hallelujah. have a treasure, it's something you value. Yes. You don't take it lightly. Yes. You preserve it. Yes. You know, if you've ever gone to a car show, and I just look at it because Pastor Reggie loves cars, and we used to go down and see the shows, they got everything roped off. Not only is it roped off, but there's people standing attention, and you're not going to come across that rope, okay? And it's a car. But now here's the treasure on the inside of you. Have you even began to understand what the treasure is intended to do for us? Amen? Or does it just lie dormant on the inside of us? And are we just praying out of our intellect, God, I hope you can do that. God, I wish you can do that. But I dare you to begin to say, Holy Ghost, that live on the inside of me. I'm believing you to birth me into the very place. Protect me to what God desires to do through me. Amen? Oh, hallelujah. Yes. Oh, yeah. Yes. See, we've seen so much from man. But this work from God can't come through man. Amen? It's much greater than our intellect. So I hear the Lord saying, Marquita, I want you to get up and stop being distracted by everything out here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I want you to just commune with me just a little bit more. Yeah. Hallelujah. Because it's in that place where the Holy Spirit begins to illume and give you the power to recognize the work of God and what God desires to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes.
See, last year, God said, I want you to begin to pray. And I don't want you to ask me for anything. I want you to just pray and sit at my feet, and I'm going to give the direction for what I want you to do. Now, I can tell you, that was difficult for me. Yeah, you know why? Because my prayer has been a prayer of what I've organized, and this is what I think it should be. Amen? But God says, you don't even know how to pray what I want. Not just me, any of us. Hallelujah. So let's go to this scripture and let's take a look at what God wants to teach us today. Spiritual awakening. Can we go to Romans chapter 8, verse 26 through 28? We're going to look at. Hallelujah. Ooh, see, God's in a place in 2019. He's always been there. He's always desired to move through us. But unfortunately, most often, intellectually, we get an understanding from what God's word is saying. And that's okay, because we have to start somewhere. Amen?
Amen.
But God don't want us to stay there.
Right.
I want you at some point to get past your intellect and realize that the Spirit of the Lord in you knows more than you know.
Yeah.
But most often, and we do this, and we don't think we're guilty of it, but we are. We begin to tell God what we want God to do in our lives. But really what God wants you and I to do is seek him so he can tell us and give us instruction on what he desires to do in our lives. But we come to him in that form and in that manner with an expectation that he's going to move. God, I want you to do this. And God, I want you to do that. But see, here's what I found out about God. In that early stage of getting to know him, he allows you to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And he will answer that. But when you get to a place of maturity, see, we didn't got all set in and I've been giving God instructions and God's been moving. And we think that's how that thing's supposed to go.
Come on now.
But see, now when you get to a mature state, a little bit more mature in him, God is saying, no, it is not time for you to instruct me. I want you to sit at my feet like Mary did, learn of me, and let me give you instruction.
Yeah.
You don't know that's difficult for most people of God.
That's right.
Because we have a confidence in what we know.
Yeah.
And see, all the times we don't know everything
that's
we need
right.
to know.
Right.
But the Holy Ghost does. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, I was thinking about how when Pastor Reggie and I, early on in our marriage, it was so much contention. Because I had my way.
Come on now.
That I wanted to do it. He had his way that he wanted to do it. Now, you know, in my eyes, his way was not the right way. And see, in his eyes, I was not being subject to the man of God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And so you think you know in the natural from your intellect what needs to take place.
Right. Right.
How many times have we attempted to minister to the people of God from our intellect?
Right. That's right.
results that God wants. Because all you and I see is on the surface in the intellect. But see, the Holy Spirit can take you to the deep roots of the issue. Amen. And when the Holy Ghost begins to show you that this is the real issue, even though you over here thinking it's this. But when you begin to pray and honor what God is saying, that this is the real issue, then change comes. Amen. Hallelujah. So here we are in 2019. And God is saying, I want you to get to a place where you're no longer spiritually detached. Because it's the heart where the Holy Spirit comes and lives in our human spirit. Amen? Yes. See, intellect does not birth anything from God. Intellect does not even create you to be the new creation that God has already called you to be. See, God says that because we're born again, make him our Lord and Savior, he calls you and I a new creation. See, something new means you don't even know how it's created and what it's supposed to do. But for whatever reason, from our intellect, we begin to try to know God and follow God in a spiritual recreation out of our intellect.
Amen.
But God is saying, no, that is not what I'm talking about. It can't happen from here. It has got to happen from the Holy Ghost. Amen. God, the Holy Ghost, is the one that causes us to be recreated in the image of God. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. So I was saying that with Pastor Reggie, early on in our marriage, we used to have this contention. And see, because the contention was there, I've learned this so much about men. You may be in a good place today and feeling good about everything. But sometimes they still thinking about what you did last year. And see, what you did last year is still in their mind. So as much as you may be approaching change, it's hard for them to see the change because they're still looking at, you disrespected me here, you did that, you did that. So then he used to have these mood swings. And I used to just detest it. So here I am, woman of God, young in God, knowing the word of God, and I feel like if I just begin to speak the word over him, he's going to bring some changes, amen? Yeah. God's going to bring a change. Now the change came, but it wasn't the change I was looking for. Because when I begin to speak that word over him, can you imagine the contention and everything that begins to go on? Because see, you're functioning out of your intellect. Because if you get to the place of what God is saying in Isaiah 29, that you're no longer just having lip service with me, you're no longer learning me from your intellect, but you're beginning to know me from your heart by the Holy Ghost, you won't even come at a situation that way anymore. You begin to see God, the Holy Ghost. Amen. Because you understand, I don't know. Hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah. So here it is, we've been struggling, trying to get this ministry going and get this ministry off the ground. And we've been doing some things tirelessly for 8 whole years.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But it's good, you know why? Because when you wear yourself out, it brings you to the place that you can go nowhere but God. Amen. Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Because only God knows.
Yes,
only God knows.
Yeah.
But see, from our natural insight. Ooh, and it's good because naturally it's got to come here to enter here so then God can begin to change it and redirect us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
See, let me make some distinctions here. See, the word is alive and it is powerful. And there's instructions in the word. But when we begin to come to a place where God no longer wants walking in spiritual blindness, there has to be an understanding of God's order. And there has to be boundaries. But see, we're not so concerned about God's order. We just know what we want to do and how we want to do it. But see, God's order is, I am God the Father. Jesus Christ is God the Son. And through God the Son, I give you salvation. But through God the Holy Ghost is your revelation. And if you don't go through God the Holy Ghost, all your revelation is intellectual. It is nothing but natural. and down here sometimes because you're functioning out of yourself.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Word, good word, good
word. Romans 8:26 yes. through 28.
Wow.
Hallelujah. See, God has some specifics, but then he has also some instruction.
Right.
So if you say, and God tells us we don't know how to pray here. But let me break this down before we read that. Because he gives us instruction on how to pray. Because he said, when you pray, say, our Father.
Wow.
Now that is instruction.
Yes,
but in your life, say for instance, if you're praying and you're asking God for a husband, he will teach you how to pray for a husband.
Right.
But if the word doesn't tell you who that husband is. So the Holy Spirit brings it specific to who the husband is to you. But it doesn't happen just because we're showing up for church, just because we're showing up for Bible study. It happens when there's an intimate relationship being developed. I'm spending time with God. I'm understanding his order. That I'm going to have to subject and submit myself to God. Amen? The Father. Allow the salvation and the confession that I've made to cause my heart to begin to get in line with what God is doing through God, Jesus Christ. Because
yes, yes.
The Bible teaches us plainly, when we make Jesus Christ our Lord and Savior,
yes.
then the righteousness is unto us as we believe.
Yes.
Not here, but in here. Amen?
Amen?
And so here's God the Holy Ghost that's always trying to direct us. Always trying to get us to spend time, but we over here distracted, no boundaries built, spending no time, hardly ever. But we're so busy doing the work of the ministry. I'm telling you, the work of the ministry will kill you, and you won't have any evidence for what God wants to do. Amen.
Wow.
You satisfied a lot of people, but where is God in this satisfaction?
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah! Oh, hallelujah! See, here it is. We can pray. Because God gives us instructions on prayer. But if you want the specifics to what God wants to do in your life and what he wants to do through you, it's going to require God the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So let's read Romans chapter 8, starting in verse 26. It says, so too, the Holy Spirit comes to our aid and bears us up in our weakness. For we do not know what prayer to offer nor how to offer it worthily as we ought. But the Spirit himself goes to meet our supplication and pleads in our behalf with unspeakable yearnings and groanings too deep for utterance. So doesn't that scripture say we ourselves don't even know worthily what we ought to pray? The Holy Spirit does. So when I follow the instruction here and I begin to call on God the Holy Ghost or God the Holy Spirit, then I need your direction. See, there's a difference when I spend my prayer time and I'm on my knees and I'm saying, God, I need you to do this. And Holy Ghost, I ask you to do this. That's not allowing God to move by his Spirit.
Yes.
That's our intellect trying to instruct
yes.
God on what to do.
Yes.
But God says your intellect is taking you to a place where you're spiritually blind to what I want to do in your life. But if you allow him and be still and wait and say, Holy Ghost, you are God the Holy Ghost. Deal with me on rebellion. And you want to know how difficult that was? Because in my eyes, I'm like rebellion. I do this, I do this, I respect this, I respect that. And so when I got to the place, finally, when I said, okay, God, I want to hear you, then God begins to show me. This is where the rebellion is. Because, see, I've given instruction. Because you're moving from your intellect. You're allowing what you to see to lead you and not what I'm saying. And see, I know I'm not the only one that's having that issue. But see, what God wants to do is get us to the place where we're willing to submit unto the Spirit of God. Because God has order. So anytime I'm going before God the Father, and I understand that I'm born again and I have salvation and I have life eternal through God Jesus Christ, but then God, Holy Spirit, is saying, I want you to just be still. But even when he's saying, be still, I'm still moving. Because I got to see something change. And sometimes we want change so bad that we just start doing a bunch of stuff. And is that bunch of stuff really working? Most often it takes us further back than where we started out. So it's called rebellion. Anytime I'm going against the order of what God has. So when Paul is on his way to Damascus and God knocks him off the horse, and then God told him to go into the city, and Ananias would give him instruction. So I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, well, God, you're the one knocked him off the horse. Why can't you tell him what you want to tell him? You know why? Because God has order. He has order. And if God is respecting his order, do you think we get an opportunity not to? So his order was that I've already instructed Ananias that you're coming. And Ananias knows that when you get there, I've given him the words to speak, and I've given him the power and the anointing to move the blindness from your eyes. Amen. So then you'll see, and then you'll move in what I called you to do. And he wrote 66, pretty much great part of the New Testament. Amen. From the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So what makes you and I think that we can go any other way? It is God the Father. It is God the Son. And it is God, the Holy Ghost, that leads us. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then verse 27 says, and he who searches the hearts of men knows what is in the mind of the Holy Spirit, what his intent is, because the Spirit intercedes and pleads before God in behalf of the saints according to and in harmony with God's will. So does that scripture have to be any clearer to say, if you desire to feel the will of God, you're going to have to go through and spend time and understand God, the Holy Spirit. Amen? Oh, hallelujah. Not this thing. Because we acquire a lot of knowledge. And when we sit under the word of God, and even these scriptures today, I ask that you go back and just begin to sit and say, God, the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit function is, the Bible says, he's our advocate. He's our teacher. He's our paraclete. So he's right here alongside to help. But we don't understand that we need to follow the paraclete. We're trying to pull the paraclete over here with what we want to do. Oh, hallelujah. But God says not so. I have order. I have order. And not only do I have order, but you got to build some boundaries. See, you can't respond to everything when people call you because it distracts you. But you need to say, God, the Holy Ghost, is this what I am to do? And then you do it. But see, you find yourself doing so many things of trying to do a good deed, but is it the deed that God wants to do? A lot of times I found out we prohibit God from working in the lives of people because we come to rescue and to save them, and God wants to use the challenge to change them and bring them to him. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. The Holy Ghost. What his intent is. Because he knows the heart and the will of God. So he's pleading on our behalf. Now God, I just ask that you cause them to continue to have the hunger, to sit at my feet, to spend time in my word, and then just be still. Play some worship music and be still and be quiet. But it's hard for us to be quiet. We feel like we gotta still keep talking and talking and talking. Because if you're doing all the talking, you're not doing any listening. And the Holy Spirit wants to speak to us. Amen?
Amen.
He has direction for us. He has guidance specific for what you and I need. Spiritual awakening. Because there's a treasure within. And a power is done by God. Hallelujah. And verse 28 says, oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We are assured and know that God, being a partner in their labor, all things work together and are fitting into a plan for good to and for those who God are called according to his design and purpose. Now listen to that. It says we are assured to know that God, being a partner in their labor, all things work together. We are assured to know that God, the Holy Ghost, being a partner in your labor, then all things work together for us. Amen? But not when you and I are out here in front and we're dictating what needs to take place. Because with our natural eyes, we can see what needs to take place. Amen? But spiritually, we don't have a clue on how to go about that. We think we do. But most often, the direction we take from our own process of what we feel we should do is nothing but dealing with something from the surface. But when I begin to spend time with the Holy Ghost, then the Holy Spirit takes me to a place. It don't look like the right place because the Holy Spirit is dealing with the deep root of the thing. But if we just stay there, we'll see. And dealing with this deep root, then it takes care of all this out here. But we know how to see this out here, but the Holy Spirit is the only one that can cause you and I to see the deep root of what God wants to change. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory. See, spiritually blind is when I only see things on the surface from what I see with my eyes, and I respond from my own thought process. But then when my heart begins to call on the Holy Ghost, then I begin to get connected with what God wants to do by his Spirit. Then God himself begins to lead us and give us the guidance and the instruction to see the deliverance for what God wants to do. The very specifics of what God wants. See, I bumped into it a time or two. Not really knowing that I was there, but I realized this was God. See, when we found this place, I was looking, when God said, I want you to take this ministry out of your house and I want you to get into a location. At that time, we didn't have the finances to even begin to look for a location, but God said, look, amen?
Amen.
Now, I have to be honest with you and tell you, when God said it, I didn't get to running to looking for one because my mind knew one thing. I didn't have the finances to look for a location. So in my mind, I'm waiting until I get the finances to do it. But then, see, God surrounds you with resources, with people. But there was a young lady named Debbie who used to work my last nerve. And she would say, oh, did you go look for a building today? And I think, why does she keep asking me for a building? Then I told her, I said, I don't even have the money for a building. She said, I know, but God said it, so let God do it. And so when people say that to you, and you're in a stuck place, and you know you don't have enough, guess what you say? They don't understand where I am. You know what? I'm not paying them no attention. But they know greater in the spirit than you know where you are in your natural state. So God didn't let her give up, even though sometimes I was rude and said, you know, don't keep asking me that. She kept coming around like, oh my God. So I thought, you know what, let me go look for a building. But my intent was to prove to her it wasn't time yet. Because I wasn't before God in the spirit to realize it's time to move. But God had already moved on somebody else. Hallelujah. So because of her annoying me, I went and I started looking. And I saw the prices on these buildings. I thought, see, I knew I couldn't afford no building. But I'm riding down Lindbergh. And I heard the Lord say, the building is right there. And I'm like, well, where is the building? Because, you know, you got to come a long way down that street. And I have passed by Lindbergh a many days, and I never saw this building. But at that time, another church was meeting in this building. But the Holy Ghost is at work, you see.
Yes.
Because now I'm beginning to obey the instruction, whether I understand it or see it or not, I'm being obedient.
Right. Yes.
Even though I'm being sarcastic and callous, I'm being obedient.
Yes.
But the Holy Spirit himself will begin to come and make your heart tender unto him. Where you can begin to say, you know what? Maybe I need to stop saying what I don't have.
Yes.
And let God be God.
Yes.
To see his greatness in my life, amen? Because see, I'm a limited source, but the Holy Spirit is an unlimited source.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So then I came on down. Nobody was here. I looked it up and called. Nobody answered. Called a couple times. Nobody answered. I left messages, didn't return my call. And then Debbie said, oh, did you ever call him? I said, I called and nobody answered. She said, oh, call him again. So the third time I called, the pastor of this house answered that phone. I was like, oh God, why did he answer? Because then I said, you know, I would like to meet with you and to see if I can begin to hold meetings in your church. 2009. Pastor Jeremy, he said, yeah, come on in, let's talk. So he and I are having a conversation. And he said, so tell me about the ministry. And we began to tell him his New Life Ministries. And at that time, we were meeting in here on Saturdays. But see, God had a plan. How did we go from Saturdays? And then in the next year, 2010, they said, the pastor in here is going out. Will you guys begin to pastor in this ministry? How did I know? And that's what God wanted to do. I did not know. But the Holy Ghost knows. Amen? So don't begin to count it lightly when God is instructing you to do something that's out of yourself. Because that's how God moves. He's bigger than us. Amen? But in our intellect, even though we say God is great and God is powerful, he can do all things, our perception is so limited that we don't let the God that can do all things be all things to us. Amen? But today, I believe by the power of the Holy Ghost that he is breathing life. And he's breathing life and giving us a faith that we haven't had before, where we can step out and begin to see the evidence of a supernatural God at work in our lives. Amen? Because see, when you are stuck, you need the anointing. When you're in a place and you don't have direction and you're not sure which way to go, you need the anointing. The anointing is the oil of God. See, that oil gets things moving. And when things get moving, the Holy Spirit himself begins to give specific direction for you and I. Amen? Because he has specifics. God has specifics to remove the blinders from our eyes. So now you and I can begin to see the deep things of God. Amen? The very specific will that he desires to do in us and through us and for us. In the name of Jesus, God the Holy Ghost. The treasure within. A spiritual awakening is what God is calling for in 2019. Yes. If you're going to move out in faith and you're going to move out in my order, you're going to have to come before me by God the Holy Ghost. Amen? Hallelujah. I have one more scripture and I'm just about done. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 6 through 7. If someone has the King James Version, I would like for you to read that. And behind that, I'm going to read the Amplified Version. So it's 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7. Because God said in that prophecy with Isaiah, I desire to do marvelous things before you and in you. I haven't changed my mind. But I want to make you aware that you're in a place where you're spiritually in a stupor. That you're following me through your intellect. You're even taking time when you're learning of me and you're honoring me with your lips. But he says, your heart is far from me. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, God, yeah. We desire to have our hearts connected. Where you, God, the Holy Ghost, can begin to minister through us. Where we can begin to see and witness and attest to this is God. And have an obedience to stay, even when we don't understand, so we can see you move in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness. When we're in a spiritual stupor, darkness is ignorance into the things that God desires to do. And the specifics of what God desires to do. But when this light comes from the Holy Spirit, then we're no longer in darkness. We begin to see, and the Holy Spirit begins to direct. But it says, for God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. So the light of the knowledge, the understanding of the knowledge, the wisdom of the knowledge that God has. The faith of the knowledge that God has. Because most often what God is calling us to do, because it's bigger than you and I, we're a little bit fearful. We're not courageous to step out. But when we begin to sit before God and spend time in his presence, that's where the awesomeness of the Holy Holy Spirit begins to change our thinking and our perception. That's where God the Holy Spirit begins to lead you and I, and we begin to subject ourselves unto God the Holy Spirit. See, coming to this place of a new creation, you and I can never do it on our own. It has to be done by God the Holy Ghost. Amen? If the Holy Ghost doesn't do it, it won't get done. Hallelujah. I don't care how many seminaries you attend, that word is the word of God, but it has to be alone in a life in God's order by the Holy Ghost to give you the specifics. Amen? Or you'll be nothing but a walking intellectual knowledge about the word of God with no signs, no wonders, no miracles, and powerless. But a lot of knowledge. And unfortunately, most of us as Christians today, Christian TV has gotten us so knowledgeable, but where is the power? Where is the change? Where is the transition? Where are we in the place of allowing God to really begin to transform us? Amen? It doesn't happen in the intellect. It only happens by the power of God, the Holy Ghost. Through the face of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Through the blood of Jesus Christ. Through the power of God. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, God the Holy Ghost moves. Amen? Yes. Order. It has to come from God the Father. Yes. It has to be through God Jesus Christ. And it has to be birthed by the power of God the Holy Ghost. Yes. Hallelujah. And we look at verse 7. And it says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, yes, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of ourselves. Yes. You and I, born again believers, we have this power in us. We're the earthen vessel. That the excellency of what God desires to do may be the power from God himself and not from us. Amen. Hallelujah. And what does the next scripture say in verse 8? Nick says, hallelujah. Because see, you and I can't do this. As much as we think we know, we can't do this. Hallelujah. Earthen vessel. We have a treasure. But how much are you valuing the treasure that's on the inside of you? Remember when I told you when you go to see the cars at these car shows, everything's roped off. I mean, they are polished. You can see you. You can comb your hair and see yourself in that car. It's just that much of a reflection because they spent that much time. But then here it is. We have a treasure on the inside of us. How much time are we spending so the reflection of who God is can begin to be transformed from us unto the lives of others? Amen?
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Says we're troubled on every side, yet not distressed, because we have God the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. We're perplexed, but not in despair, because I have God the Holy Spirit. Yeah. We're troubled on every side. Hallelujah. But I'm not going to allow the challenge to dictate to me who I am in God.
Amen.
But I'm going to allow God the Holy Ghost to be a treasure within, amen? A spiritual awakening from God himself today. Yeah. God hasn't forsaken us. No matter how much it feels like you're being persecuted, that you're being cast down, that you're being overlooked, that God, by now I should have this. But who are you depending on? Is your focus on God, the Holy Ghost? Or is it on you? I've gone through and I got my master's and I got my doctorate and still I'm here. Because God says it has to be done by God, the Holy Ghost. Amen? Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus Christ. See, Christ didn't die in vain, y'all. He didn't die in vain. His blood was shed so you